to the children. To receive an inheritance, for us, no need to struggle, no need to strive, no need to fight for. There are earthly inheritances also there, physical inheritance is there, and spiritual inheritance is also there. Amen. Let us turn to 1 Kings chapter 21, verse 3. 1 Kings chapter 21, verse 3.
And Naboth said to Ahab, "The Lord forbid it to me that I should give the inheritance of my fathers unto thee."
Hallelujah. Here, King Ahab, I just want to give a background about this verse. King Ahab, he liked the vineyard of Naboth. So Ahab sent a messenger to Naboth and asked for his vineyard. And he said, and he demanded that he will give the vineyard, for that vineyard, he would give a better vineyard or some other place which Naboth will choose. But Naboth refused to give the inheritance of his father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So according to the custom of Israelites, according to the custom of the land of Israel, one tribe should not give the inheritance to the other tribe. Are you following? Hello? Yes. The inheritance which they have inherited from the father, they should not give to anybody nor exchange with anybody the father, the forefathers has given. Here the Naboth says that this, "The Lord forbid that I give my inheritance to you which belong to my fathers." Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. So in the same way, the Bible talks about inheritances that... So in the same way, when you look at the Bible, there are many inheritances given for the body of Christ. Through Christ, we inherit many wonderful things by God. Hallelujah. So from the light of the Word of God, we are going to see some of the examples how people of the Bible lost the inheritance which is belong to them, which was belonging to them. Shall we turn to Genesis chapter 25, 32 to 34? Genesis 25, 32 to 34.
And Esau said, "Behold, I am at the point to die, and what profit shall this birthright do to me?"
If you have a Bible, open your Bible, because if you don't listen or understand or read, you're going to miss many things tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Isaac had two sons. The elder one is called Esau, the second one is called Jacob. According to the customs of Israel, Esau, the firstborn, will have three portions of the father's inheritance. Three portions of the father's inheritance by birthright it will come to him automatically. But one day Esau come from hunting and he was very hungry. There Esau, Jacob was cooking a stew. What is stew? It's the Bible, if you read in the Bible, it is written dal. He was making cooking dal. So Esau was very hungry and he went to Jacob, "Would you please give me a morsel of this lentil soup?" But Jacob said, "You sell me your birthright, I will give it my stew." So Esau despised his birthright and he said, "I am dying in hunger, what this birthright is going to do with me?" And he despised his birthright. He sold the birthright to Jacob. Hallelujah. It should have been returned. He is the God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Esau. But because Esau despised his birthright, that birthright came to Jacob. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the inheritance which belonged to him by birth, he just rejected it. He despised it. He lost it. Hallelujah. Esau made a permanent decision in a temporary situation. Hallelujah. In our life also, to deal with a simple situation, we make a permanent decision. Hallelujah. Through that, we lost many things in our life. Esau did not sell his birthright only, he sold his future. He sold everything and everyone connected with him and connected with him. Hallelujah. Everything and everyone's future he sold for just a morsel of the lentil soup. Hallelujah. The next example that we see is Judas, Acts chapter 1, verse 35. Acts chapter 1 verse 35 says like this.
To whom also?
31. Okay, Judas was one of the chosen disciples of Jesus Christ. But because for 30 pieces of silver, he denied and betrayed the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen? The Bible says in chapter 1, Acts chapter 1, they were selecting the 12th person because Judas was chosen to be an apostle and the ministry Jesus Christ had already planned to establish his kingdom on this earth. But because Judas has failed, they are casting a lot. Acts chapter 1, 21.
Wherefore of these men which have company, Acts chapter 1 verse 25. That he may take part of this ministry and apostleship.
So when you read Luke chapter 10, Jesus sent 2 by 2 all the disciples to go to the villages. So when they went and they came back, they reported to Jesus Christ, Lord, in your name, even demons are subjecting to us. They raised the dead, they healed the sick. Judas also did all these miracles, but for 30 pieces of silver, he betrayed Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But the truth is, Judas did not sold Jesus, but Judas sold his soul for 30 pieces of silver. Amen. He was one of the chosen disciples of Jesus Christ to do the ministry and the apostleship that was given to him, he just threw away for 30 pieces of silver. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So another example we see, Gesai. 2 Kings chapter 5 verse 21. Amen. There was a prophet called Elijah. And Elijah had a disciple called Elisha. And Elisha had a disciple called Gesai. This Gesai was a disciple of a prophet Elisha. One day, Naaman came from Syria to be healed of this leprosy. Elisha told him to go and take bath in the Jordan River. So when Naaman obeyed that, leprosy left Naaman. So when Naaman came back to Elisha to give rewards, Elisha said, I don't want your reward, keep your reward with you. When Gehazi saw that, he said, what my master is doing, I'm going to get a reward for what the master has said. So he went after Naaman's chariot and he said, two of my prophets from the school are coming. I want 2 sets of dress and silver and gold. So Gehazi received this from Naaman and came to Elisha. When came to the house, Elisha asked Gehazi, where were you? Gehazi said, I did not go anywhere, I was here. But Elisha said, did not my spirit went after you when you went after the chariot of Naaman to receive the reward? So, because you done that, the leprosy that left Naaman will cling unto you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What is the lesson that we learn here? Amen. So Elijah was the prophet of God. Amen. And Elisha was his disciple. Elijah did 8 miracles and Elisha did 16 miracles. When Elijah was carried up in the chariot into heaven, the double portion of anointing that was upon Elijah, it rested upon Elisha. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Gehazi was the prophet next in line. Hallelujah. So because of the lust and the craving for the rewards, he lost the inheritance. He lost his calling. He lost the prophetic ministry which was due to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Another example we see Samson. Amen. Judges chapter 16 verse 20. It says like this. Samson did not know the Lord left him. Amen. From birth, Samson was chosen to be a judge of Israel. He was chosen by God to be a deliverer of Israel. But he was chosen to be a Nazarene from his birth. But what all God told him not to do, that is the only thing Samson was continuously doing. Hallelujah. 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 Are you following? Amen. So he should be the judge and the deliverer of Israel, but in the end, he died as a blind man. Hallelujah. He died as a blind man. Amen. The Bible says like this, even though God fulfilled the purpose using Samson, but he had to pay for his disobedience. Amen. He had to pay with his eyes and his life for the disobedience which he walked and lived in. Amen. There are so many examples we can take from the Bible, from the Word of God, how people lost their inheritance, threw away their inheritance, rejected and despised their inheritance, which naturally, spiritually belonging to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But now, what is the inheritance that we have in Christ? Shall we all turn to John chapter 1, verse 12 and 13? John chapter 1, verse 12 and 13.
But as many as received him, to them gave the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God.
As I told you, inheritance is something that we inherit from our father. Hallelujah. There are earthly inheritance. Suppose if your father have a big bungalow or, you know, riches or estate, naturally it will come to you. Naturally it will come to you. In the same way, there are physical inheritance. Suppose if you have some diabetic problem, ask, when you go to the doctor, what the first question they'll ask? Anybody is having diabetic or hypertension in your family? Amen? So in the same way, there is a spiritual inheritance that Bible talks about. John chapter 1, verse 12 and 13, it says like this, but those who received him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Hallelujah. The moment you believe and receive Jesus Christ as a Lord and Savior, God gives the right to become his son and daughter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The moment you put your faith in Jesus Christ and receive him as a Lord and Savior, God the Father gives you your right, gives you a privilege, gives you an heritage to be his son and daughter. Hallelujah. How many sons and daughters of God here? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, when we believe in Jesus Christ, this spiritual inheritance has come into our lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, the greatest inheritance that we can receive in this life is a relationship with our Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. The greatest thing in all the life is the relationship that we enjoy with our Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. The Bible says, even though we were dead in our sins, but God, who is rich in mercy, according to his great love, he has raised us from our dead life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the greatest inheritance that we received in this life is the Father's love. Amen. The Father's love. Hallelujah. So many of us, maybe some of us have a father who abused us in our childhood. He's not a perfect father. The earthly father does not show how a father should be. Hallelujah. The Bible talks about one perfect father, that is God in heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He loves them with an everlasting love. Amen. He loves them with an everlasting love. He loves us just as we are. Amen. It doesn't matter how good and how bad you are. He loves us just as we are. Hallelujah. 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 So this, we are living in the world where people are longing for love. Amen. We don't see true love. We don't see true love even in family, in society, everywhere. Hallelujah. If you love me, I will love you. Amen. Love becomes so selfish. Amen. Love becomes so conditional. Love becomes so violent. Amen. But God the Father loves him with an everlasting love. Amen. Are you seeking in this night a true love? You cannot get the true love in this world. Amen. You will not get the true love from any man or woman. Amen. The true love you can receive only from the Heavenly Father. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says, Paul writes like this, I am convinced, I am persuaded, I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor demons, nor principalities nor power, nor height nor depth, nor present nor the future, nor any other created thing will be able to separate me from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Hallelujah. Do you understand the meaning of this verse? Even death cannot separate us from the from the Father's love. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Even the death cannot separate us from the Father's love. Hallelujah. The next verse says, John 15:15.
Henceforth I call you not servants.
I did not call you servants. I don't call you servants, but I call you friends. Because a servant does not know about his master's business. But I call you friends because whatever I heard from the Father, I show it to you, reveal it to you. Hallelujah. Jesus is our best friend. Hallelujah. Jesus is our best friend. Amen. We cannot share everything with our husband. We cannot share everything with your wife. We cannot share everything with our parents. We cannot share everything with our children. We cannot share everything with our brothers and sisters. But with Jesus, we can share everything. Amen. Hallelujah. He is our best friend. Amen. He is the friend who can stick with you until the last. Hallelujah. Many friends comes and go in our life. But this friend called Jesus, he will stick to us. He will be with us until the end of our life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the Bible talks about our inheritance in Christ Jesus. The Bible says that we are partakers of his heavenly calling. We are partakers of his holiness. We are partakers of the Holy Spirit. We are the partakers of his suffering. 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 and 4, it says like this. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Can you please? Which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again into a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible, undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God has begotten you again. God has chosen you again. God has gave you new birth again, so that you may inherit an inheritance which is incorruptible. Hallelujah. Unfading, undefiled, which is reserved in heaven for you. Hello. There is a treasure, there is an inheritance reserved in heaven for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't have inheritance now. What inheritance? What I'm going to enjoy inheritance in heaven? That is many of our questions. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So blessing is not how much you have. The real blessing is not how much we have, how much bank balance we have, what kind of car I drive, what kind of salary I receive. The true blessing is who we are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. The true blessing is what we are, how we are, where we are, and who we are in Christ Jesus. That is the true blessing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you read the book of Ephesians, it is called the Queen of Epistles. There are 6 chapters. First 3 chapters talks about who we were, who we are now in Jesus Christ, and what is our identity in Jesus Christ. The next 3 chapters talks about how we are to live this new life in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1 to 5. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1 to 5. And you have been quickened who are dead in trespasses and sins, wherein time past you walk according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now works in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation in time past, in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and thereby nature the children of wrath, even as others. Hallelujah. The Bible says, in the past, we were living and fulfilling the desires of the mind and the desires of the flesh. Therefore, we were children of wrath. Children of wrath for God. The verse 4 says, but God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love, he with which he loved us, he raised us from our dead situation. Amen. Hallelujah. He raised us from, even when we were dead, he raised us together with Christ. By grace we have been saved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you following? Hallelujah. See, people get excited when when pastors or leaders speak about healing. Speak about deliverance. Amen. But when we speak about the word of God, everybody is very serious. Hallelujah. But this is the word that will change our lives. Amen. The word of God alone will change our lives. Hallelujah. So unless we understand who we are, unless we understand who we are in Christ Jesus, it is very difficult to live a Christian life. Amen. Christian life is far more than we imagine or thinking. Amen. Amen. So Ephesians chapter 2 verse 11 to 13. Wherefore, remember that you, being in time past Gentiles the flesh, who are called uncircumcision by that which is called the circumcision in the flesh made by hands, that at the time you were without Christ, being aliens from the covenant of Israel, and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope, and without God in the world. But now in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were far off are made near by the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God has chosen Israel as the most treasured people among all the peoples of the earth. Hallelujah. To Israel belong all the covenants, all the promises, all the blessings. Hallelujah. We were outside the covenant of God. We were outside the commonwealth of God. But through Christ Jesus, God has made Gentiles and Israelites together. Hallelujah. We are Gentiles, but through the blood of Jesus Christ, we are made one with Israel to inherit the promises, the blessings which God has promised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17 says, therefore, you are a new creation in Christ Jesus. All old things are passed away, but behold, all things have been made new. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says we are new creation in Christ Jesus. Jesus made a new creation. Hello. Hello. Are you there?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So Jesus has given us a new identity. Jesus has given us a new image which we lost in the garden. Jesus has given us a new dignity and authority in Him. Hallelujah. So the Bible gives us a new identity. Amen. In the world, we are identified by our name, by our stature, by our work that we do, by our car that we drive, by the church we attend, by the family that we come from. The world identifies and gives a different kind of image. But the Bible, in the light of the scripture, gives us a new meaning to our image. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hello. Are you following? Amen. The Bible gives us a new identity. The Bible gives us a new image because what Jesus Christ has done on the cross of Calvary. Amen. The Bible says we are the saints of God in Christ Jesus. Hello. There is no saints. We are the children of the Most High God. We are the citizens of heaven. We are the ambassadors of Christ. We are the fragrance for Jesus Christ our Lord. We are the salt of this earth for Jesus. We are the light of this world for Jesus. We are seated with Christ in heavenly places. Hello. I'm talking about you. Hello. I'm talking about you. This is your identity. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So that is your identity. You are a child of God. You are a saint of God. The Bible says that you are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, chosen generation, people belonging to God. Hallelujah. Do you know that you belong to God? Amen. Do you know that you are a royal priest? Do you know that you are a chosen one of the living God? Hallelujah. That is your identity. Amen. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1, we are blessed with every spiritual blessings in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are already blessed. Amen. You are already blessed in Christ Jesus in every way. God has promised. Amen. The Bible says, if you read further, Ephesians chapter 1, it talks about your identity in Jesus Christ. We are predestined by God in Christ Jesus. We are adopted by God in Christ Jesus. We are accepted by God in Christ Jesus. We are redeemed by God in Christ Jesus. We are forgiven by God in Christ Jesus. We are redeemed by God in Christ Jesus. You are seated with Christ in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Physically you are sitting here, but according to the word of God, your spiritual standing is you are sealed with Christ in heavenly places. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Unless we understand our identity in Christ Jesus and what He has done, it's very difficult to live a Christian life. Amen? Amen? So the Christian life is not what we do to be a Christian. Christian life is all about what we become, what we have to become, which God has intended us to be. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jesus has done everything necessary and possible so that we might inherit that great inheritance which is reserved for us in heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus was condemned so that we might be justified. Amen. He was crushed so that we might be healed. He was rejected so that we might be accepted. He became sin so that we might become righteousness of God. He became cursed so that we might receive the blessings of Abraham and Isaac. He became naked on the cross so that we might be clothed with the robe of righteousness and salvation. He took our death so that we might live. He rose again from the dead so that we may not die again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The work that Jesus Christ did on the cross is a completed work. Amen. That's why Jesus said, when it is finished, when he said it is finished, everything that is negative, that is opposite, that was not possible, that was against us, everything is finished. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. So there are so many wonderful inheritances and the promises of God written in the Bible for us. Hallelujah. So it is our responsibility to possess those inheritance which is given to us through our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Our Christian life will be powerless. Our Christian life will be purposeless if you don't understand who you are in Christ Jesus and if you don't understand what Christ has done for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the Bible says in Romans chapter 8 verse 29. Amen. This is the purpose of our Christian life. Romans 8, 29. Mark this verse. This is the purpose of our Christian life. For whom he did foreknew, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The purpose of our Christian life is conforming to the image of the Son of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The purpose of our Christian life, the goal of our Christian life is to become like Jesus. Amen. We have to become like Jesus. Conform to the image of the Son of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jesus did everything possible so that you might be confirmed, translated, transformed into the image of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So unless we understand what Christ has done for me, unless we understand what is my image and identity in Christ Jesus, our Christian life will be powerless, purposeless. Hallelujah. For every one of you, there is a purpose. Hallelujah. Whether you believe or not, whether you know or not, you have a definite purpose of God in your life. Hallelujah. You have a definite purpose of God in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So you have to understand that. You have to fulfill that. How to fulfill that purpose? Amen. I want this because you're all very, look like sleeping. I just want to tell you a story. Hallelujah. So there was slavery in practice in the land of America in those days. Amen. So when Abraham Lincoln became the president of United States of America, he wanted to abolish the practice of slavery. So he passed the order that this slavery should be abolished completely from this country of America. So when the masters of the slaves heard this news, they were very sad. All of them gathered together and they had a meeting. This president had declared this new law that the slavery should be abolished from this nation. So who is going to work for us? Who will help us? Who will do this, all this work? So one smart master student said, Abraham Lincoln passed the law, but we make sure that the servant, the slaves, will not hear about this law. Hello? Yes. Are you following? Yes. If you make the slaves not to hear about the law, they will be continually be a slave. be a slave with a slave mentality. Hallelujah. One more example I'll give you so that you may understand what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Elephant is one of the strongest animals on the planet Earth. But when the elephant is very small, they will tie the elephant leg with a simple rope. Amen? The elephant will grow. But still, they will tie the elephant with the same simple rope. What is the mind of the elephant? The elephant think that, I cannot leave this rope because this is untied to the rope. But the elephant did not know the power that it has to break the rope. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Many of us living our Christian life also like that. Hallelujah. Because we do not understand the truth of the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We like to hear about blessing. We like to hear about healing. We like to hear prophecies. That is all we like to hear. But we don't want to hear the truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's very important that you know the truth. Because unless you know the truth, you will never be free. Amen. Jesus said that you shall know the truth and the truth will set you free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To inherit the promise, amen, there are so many inheritance that Jesus Christ has given. Amen. When you go home, read Ephesians chapter 1 to 3. Hallelujah. It is speaking about you. It is speaking about each and everyone who accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Amen. So to inherit these promises, to receive these promises, to make these promises into a reality in our life, we need faith. We need faith. Hallelujah. Hello. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We need faith. Amen. Faith is not about receiving things. The Bible gives a beautiful definition for faith. Hebrews 11 chapter 1, it says like this. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hello. Can we read that verse? Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. Amen. He did not say that faith is asking. Faith is built. No. It's about what it says. Substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jesus called us saints. Amen. If we analyze our life very deeply, we are not living like saints. Hello. Yes or no?
Yes.
But Jesus tells me you are a saint. Amen. But in reality, I'm not a saint. Amen? Because inside there is so much garbage is there. Amen? But God calls me a saint. Is God a liar? No. But God is telling that you are a saint. Amen? I will explain to you. Now, God came to speak to Abraham. God told to Abraham that I will make you a father of nations. When Abraham came out of the land of Ur, his name was called Abraham. What is his name? Abraham. He was 99 years, more than 75 years old. His Sarah was also old. She passed the age of childbearing. And Abraham also very old. Now God comes to Abraham and he says, I want to make a covenant with you. And if you believe and walk with me, I will make you father of many nations. And God changed his name, Abraham. Hallelujah. God changed his name from Abraham to Abraham. Hallelujah. Now, 80 years passed. 90 years passed. Wherever Abraham goes, Abraham was going from place to place. Whoever asks his name, what he says? What's your name? He is telling Abraham or Abraham?
Abraham.
My name is Abraham. You know why? Because Abraham believed what God has said. Hallelujah. 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 So, Abraham believed what God has said. Amen. Eventually, this Abraham became Abraham, the father of many nations. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know that through faith, we are also children of Abraham? Hello. He is our father. Amen. Because he believed the promise of God. Hallelujah. Faith is essential to receive the inheritance The Lord has promised to us. Second example I will give it to you. God came to deliver the people of Israelites. And he told them, I am going to take you to a land flowing with milk and God has promised. Amen. So everyone, all the 6 lakh people heard the promise of God. They know where they were going. Amen. But two spies, amen, they believe that we are going to enter into that land. We are going to possess the promised land. All the people, most of the people who came out of the land of Egypt, they were all perished in the wilderness. Amen. Only two spies, to Joshua and Caleb, and the generation that was next, amen, they entered the promised land. Hallelujah. The promise was given to everyone, but only two believed. Rest of them all did not believe. They all perished in the wilderness. Hallelujah. If you believe what Christ has said about me is true, is real, it will become yours. Hallelujah. If you don't believe, if you question it with a logical mind, amen, the loser is you. Hallelujah. Hello. Are you following? So God calls us, we are saints of God. Abraham believed God. Amen. Abraham had immovable faith in God. What God we are talking about? Amen. What is the nature of God? What is the character of God? Hallelujah. God, the Bible says in Romans chapter 4, he calls the things that are not as that they were. Hallelujah. He raises the dead. He has the power and ability to do what he has promised. Amen. If God has promised you something in your life, amen, he has the power, he has the ability also to fulfill what he has promised in your life. Hello. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 1 shows a beautiful thing about God's word and his power. Amen. So the Bible says Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the water. Can you all read the words 2 together? And the earth was? So Genesis chapter 1 verse 2 says, the earth was without? The earth was without? What is the form of the earth? What is the form of the earth? What is the shape of the earth? Hello? We have studied school. It's round. It's circular. Hallelujah. This shapeless, this formless earth become a beautiful place for human beings to dwell because God, when he spoke, that word brought the life and this creation into place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So whatever God has predestined, whatever God has pre-planned, whatever God has designed and purposed in his heart, he spoke. Whatever he spoke, that thing came into reality. Hallelujah. Bible says in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 11, when God says like this, the word which I sent will not return to me void, but it will fulfill the purpose for which I have sent. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So when God spoken something in your life, when God gives a word into your life, it will bring the purpose for which it has been sent. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every promise and every word of God has life within itself and the power to produce, to bring forth, to create, to make what it promises. Hello. Hallelujah. When God says something, he will make sure that he will bring it to pass. Hallelujah. So when God spoke, everything came into being. You know why? When God said, everything came into existence. You know why? The earth yielded to the Lord's word. The earth responded to God's word. The earth received the word of God. In the same way, when God speaks a word into your life, when God gives a promise into your life, if you receive it with faith, that word will come to pass in your life. Hello? That promise will come to pass in your life. That word will come to promise in your life. Amen? It's your faith in the word of God and the nature and the character of God bring the fulfillment of the promise of God into life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want the inheritance of Jesus Christ, the inheritance that is reserved for you in heaven, I mean not to enjoy in heaven, it has to be enjoyed now. Hallelujah. Eternal life is not the thing that we enjoy when we die. No. Eternal life is now. Hallelujah. Eternal life is now. You're born again now. You need to live this new life with the inheritance that Jesus Christ is now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can I take your 10 minutes more? Can I take your 10 minutes more? Amen. There is a mission. There is a mission given for all the children of God. Amen? Our God is a generational God. Our God is a generational God. Exodus chapter 20 verse 6. Exodus chapter 20 verse 6. I'm showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. And also read Malachi 2 verse 15. And did not he make one? Yet had he the residue of the Spirit, and therefore one, that he might seek a godly seed. God seeks a godly generation. Hallelujah. As parents, we understood and we received the inheritance, but what God expects. Children are the heritage of the Lord. The fruit of the womb is his reward, the Bible says. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So as we read and studied about inheritance, my inheritance I have to give to my children. My heritage, my property, I have to give to my son and my daughter. Hallelujah. Hello. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. So I have supposed to give all my inheritance and my heritage to my son, to my daughter. Hallelujah. The greatest inheritance that you can give to your child is not wealth, is not money, it's Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can give anything to your child that is not going to be a blessing for your child. Give Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Otherwise, Christianity and the church life will be a casual thing for our children. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lead them to have a personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Help them to understand what is the portion of inheritance they have in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. As you understood, as you know who you are in Christ Jesus, what is your inheritance in Christ Jesus, make your children to understand their identity in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. If you don't teach, the world will teach a different thing. Hello. If you don't teach, the world is going to teach a different thing for your child. Hallelujah. It is our responsibility to transfer this inheritance, greater inheritance that we have from Christ to our children. Amen. So when you read the Bible, there are many examples how the father failed to give their inheritance to the children. Amen. Samuel, Eli, Aaron, they are priests of God. They had sons. Amen. But when the time of the father was over, the sons took control of the post of the priesthood. Amen. Because they did not understand what is called a priesthood. Because they did not understand what is called the temple of God, they defiled the temple of God. And the Bible says God killed them. Amen. God killed them. Hallelujah. David was a man after God's own heart. Hallelujah. He had a desire to build the house of God. But God told him that you will not build. You are a man of your man filled blood in your hands. Your son will build. So David stored everything to build the temple of God. Here, the time of David is over. Solomon became king of Israel. 40 years there was no war. Complete peace in the land of Israel. Solomon built the temple, not only the temple, but he built temple for every wife he got married to. Hello. Not only he built the temple of God, but also he built a temple for every wife he got married to. He brought idols of various countries into the land of Israel and defiled the land. Amen. Like David, Solomon was not a warrior. Like David, Solomon was not a worshipper. Like David, Solomon was not a wanderer. Everything was given to him in platter. That's why he was not able to value the inheritance given by the Father. Hallelujah. Make your children to understand the value of the inheritance that you had from Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Finally, God has given this inheritance, great inheritance, Jesus as our Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Paul raised Timothy and many more disciples. Jesus raised 12 more disciples. How many disciples you have raised so far? Amen. Hallelujah. The 12 went out into the world and made the world upside down. Amen. Hallelujah. You have a great inheritance of Jesus Christ inside you. How many spiritual children you have given birth to? Hallelujah. We have given birth to physical children. How many spiritual children you have given birth to? Just like you. Hallelujah. Jesus made 12. Paul made Timothy, Onesimus, Tychicus, many disciples he made. How many spiritual children you have? Hallelujah. God is not looking for converts. God is looking for disciples. Hallelujah. God is not looking for servants. God is looking for sons. Hallelujah. God is not looking for, you know, rented workers or salaried workers. God is looking for shepherds. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have a great inheritance in Christ Jesus. Amen. You are very valuable in the eyes of God. Amen. Unless you believe and exercise your faith in what Christ has made you, amen, you will not fulfill the purpose for which God has saved you. Hallelujah. Jesus has saved you for a great purpose. And he has given you a great inheritance through which you can shake the world. You can build the kingdom. Hallelujah. May God bless you. Go home and meditate on the scriptures which you read today. Because if you don't understand your heritage, your inheritance of who you are in Christ Jesus, what Christ has done for you, your Christian life will be powerless, purposeless. May God give you the wisdom. May the Spirit of the Lord make you to understand who you are in Christ Jesus and how you can live a victorious life in Christ Jesus in this world. May God bless you. Shall we all stand?